Hello, everybody, once again. Hey, welcome back to Poppy Playtime Chapter 2. So, we're in the last video. If you watched all the way through, you know that we just fell down right down the descent. And now in this area. So, let's see. Oh my god.
I asked you to play fair, and you cheated! I hate cheaters! Now, we're going to play one last game! It's called Hide and Seek! 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Okay. I want to see something, if she would actually kill me there or not. I do apologize. Alright, so we're gonna do this little bit of the game, like try to actually finish it off here. I was kind of curious, like, if she would actually do anything in that part. Okay.
I asked you to play fair, and you cheated! I hate cheaters! We're going to play one last game! It's called Hide and Seek!
Hey. to come down, kid. Fixing to say we're about to die, that prototype has saved us. What do you mean? It should feel wonderful. It's not. I feel like the prototype is like the final boss of the game. Like in whatever the final chapter is of this game, you'd be there.
Ha ha ha!
pig. Can you see something weird? Matthews. Mr. Matthew Wason? The name of the person, nature of request, Windows in Game Station. Why? I don't know if you've ever spent weeks on end in a windowless, artificially lit room. But let me tell you something. It's far from pleasant. The kids are getting rowdy, too. You can just see it on their faces. I know there's not really a way to get natural light down here, but there's other ways, right? I'm thinking about fake windows all around. Do that and bam, there's some actual light down here. I saw it on TV last week. This underground place had fake windows, fake lights behind glass. It makes the whole place seem... I feel sunlit. It's nice. You want everyone in the right headspace for these games, don't you? It's the right thing to do. Or do the right thing. Add windows. employee instructions. Start by reporting to the control station. Keep at least 20 yards away from mommy, long legs. Only one child should ever play a game at a time. Children who are not playing a game in the will wait in the game station. There will be playground equipment to keep them entertained. Record each child's performance as it is relevant to each game. Musical memory, composure, memory, pattern recognition, wacky-wacky, hand-eye coordination, reaction time, statues, agility, speed, and strength. Once the children have left for the day, return to the control station. Give all reports to Miss Stella Graper to sort through the... You don't need to do anything. I think that spawns up there. I could be wrong, though. There's little dino fellows. And a star. Okay, there we go. That's actually a really fun way to get down. His name is Brown, right? So, okay, there we go. Yep, just kind of wiped him out the way. Just realized that. It's weird that you don't see her with you. You're like, she apparently said, like, hey, go to the train, whatever. And it's like, where is she at, though? actually moving. If you're just in one spot, and the game is just to actually have the walls and stuff, like, go down. A cool little thing. And if you've seen the, like, towards the end of the last video, you'll know, like, at the little glitch I did with Mommy Longlegs, the, corridor. You know? That's the end of the game. Chapter 2, Flying the Web. But, yeah, there's a lot of little hidden things that are, like, a part of the game. Like, to be honest, the, like, for example, PJ Pugabiller and also Mommy Longlegs are both tied to the speed of which the character or the player more so moves. And, which pretty much means that if the player is already, like, you know, like, halfway through the map, and PJ just started, you're gonna, like, okay, so, another YouTuber called Horoscope had done a video on it, and he teleported his character to the end of the map, where you go and grab the bar up top of your hand grabber thing, like, one of your hands, and pretty much looked back, and all you can see is PJ just zipping and zooming around on the maze, you know? So, yeah. And same with Mommy, like I made a second ago about the last video. You watched towards the end and you saw the little hallway area. You would see that she was going really slow. That's because both PJ and Mommy Longlegs are both kind of tied to the character's speed and distance. So that they're always kind of at, like, the same distance, no matter how fast the player goes or doesn't go or whatever. It's kind of like in that Sonic game where it's, like, the truck that chases you. You know, like, it goes really fast, and all of a sudden, like, it, when it gets close, it just blows to a crawl. You know, just smack it into you. It's kind of like that. But, yeah, there's the end of Chapter 2. Not much else to really say about that, the game. Yeah, for, like, it's kind of interesting, because, like, through the little sewer part, that's, you know, something that's also kind of interesting. Like, at a first glance, when you don't really think about it, it does kind of seem like it's just one Mommy Long Legs coming at you. Like, you know, just, it's one of them all being able to, like, grab their hands towards you and stuff, but it's really and truthfully just multiple characters, like multiple of the same model being used to kind of give that illusion of many characters, many of the same characters coming after the same character or coming after the player, you know, whatever. Yeah. And like in other shots, it's also kind of a different model being used to, like, get you the train code, like, in the wacky-looky thing, or in the musical memory. Like, and I know it's kind of, like, it kind of ruins the immersion of the game and stuff, but, yeah, that's kind of how they did it, is, like, it looks like it's one of the, just one Mommy Longlegs reaching arms and legs and all that kind of at you. But in reality, it's multiple models of the Mommy Longlegs, and where it's just like the arms reaching out towards you and all this crap. But I'm gonna stop ruining the game for y'all. I'm not gonna end this recording here. So yeah, this has been your captain speaking. I do hope that you have enjoyed, and hope to see you around the next one. Peace out, your lovely.